What is going on everyone, Nostalgia95 coming at you with another Digimon Digivolution Land video. I'm pretty excited for this one because we're going to be talking about a Digimon who was created on June 15th, 2020, meaning a very recent Digimon when you consider the date of this video's release. In our previous episode, we were brought to the Digimon's polar region and talked about Snow Agumon. If you haven't seen that episode, make sure to check it out. In this episode, we are going to explore a Digimon belonging to the Digimon's Ocean. I'm talking about the Mega Level Regalicusmon, and I'm hoping I'm not mispronouncing its name. In appearance alone, I do have to say that this one would belong to one of my favorite aquatic Digimon. It looks intimidating with the giant pincer weapon on its left arm, the sword that looks very piercing, a face that looks to be covered in some armor, the electricity. Normally when I make these explaining Digivolution Land videos, I start by discussing their rookie forms. The problem is that Regalicusmon does not seem to have any rookie, nor champion and ultimate. So what we'll do here is the reverse. We'll start discussing the mega level and spiral downwards to know more about the possible origins of our new aquatic creature. What we know about Regalicusmon is that it belongs to the Deep Savers family. Members of this field are generally aquatic or polar Digimon or those who dwell in marine areas. It does not belong to any other family, only the Deep Savers. This is already very important to remember. With this information, we know that Regalicusmon is a Digimon whose habitat is extremely limited. And obviously, when looking at its appearance, specifically its underbody, it has webbed feet. These are little aspects we're going to take into account once we're going to explain its Digivolution line. When it comes to the characteristics, the Digimon loves to repeatedly assault and loot the feeding grounds and territories of other Digimon. That is because it is a pirate. It roams from one place to another, it steals, making in the least the Digimon oceans a bit less safe. And speaking of safety, we already discussed the parts of the Digimon Arctic, and I myself came to the conclusion that it is a relatively calm environment. The Digimon forests are among the most hostile because you'd come across Digimon that move based on primitive instincts, Digimon that will cast illusions, really a dangerous environment. Because in this video I'm talking about an aquatic Digimon, I wanted to know how dangerous that environment could potentially be, and boy, you'd be surprised. Seadramon, who we explained in explaining Seadramon Digivolution Land video, is just one example of a very dangerous Digimon in that area. But did you know that there are not just one but many other pirate Digimon with their own crew? There is Captain Hookmon, a seaman Digimon and a captain with its own pirate ship and subordinates. There is Mermaidmon, another Digimon who, just like Regalicusmon, can go to extreme lengths to take what it wants. The irony is that Mermaidmon is but a leader of a pirate crew, but not the leader. It is the first mate of the Digimon Olegmon, the actual leader of a crew known as the Gold Pirate Crew, its personal army. And there is also, arguably, Bolt Bautamon, even though this one looks more like a pirate than actually is one. But this is only to show you that if stories are well written, great tales could come out of the Digimon Oceans, as the area harbors many ill-willed Digimon and other marvelous aquatic Digimon with their own agenda. It is said that Regalicusmon is the ruler of the abyss that stands at the apex of the food chain due to its overwhelming power. In this context, when we say the abyss, we do not mean the dark area, which is also pretty much an abyss considering all the demons residing there. No, when you go into the depths of the oceans, there are areas even us humans with our technology could not reach. In fact, here is a quote from National Geographic which confirms my claim. More than 80% of the ocean has never been mapped, explored, or even seen by humans. A far greater percentage of the surfaces of the moon and the planet Mars have been mapped and studied than our own ocean floor has. And these unexplored areas in our planet are places so deep that the sun rays cannot even illuminate the area. It is very, very dark over there. Unlike our interpretation of an abyss that is a place of fire and suffering, but in the least, you can see that suffering and fire. This would mean that Regalicusmon is a Digimon that can go very, very, very deep into the ocean and would probably have a natural rivalry with Digimon like Tylomon, also known as Jet Plane of the Deep. That is to say the least. There are many other mysterious aquatic Digimon. In fact, there are also godlike aquatic Digimon that are just as terrifying as Regalicusmon. Think of Neptunemon, a Digimon who resides in what is called the Abyss Sanctuary, even though the Digimon belongs to another server than the one of Regalicusmon. Now, at the beginning I mentioned the sword, right? That sword is actually the horn of Zudomon, which it teared off. We are going to talk about what exactly happened between the two in another video, because it does seem interesting. All I want to say is that, as it is the horn of Zudomon that Regalcusmon is wielding as a sword, that would mean that Regalcusmon in height would be huge. And here are comments confirming this. Let me quote. "If I saw this when I swim," said the Omnitrickster, and that comment received the following response, I quote, "Can I add to this fear in stating that it would be like running into a 15 foot tall to 18 foot tall humanoid? That dude is big enough to hold a whole Zudomon horn, and look at the size comparison. A Zudo horn is approximately 5 to 6 feet tall. Compare that horn and this thing could be roughly 20 feet tall, possibly at its biggest. So imagine that giant fish head breaking the surface, charging at you." And that is true that Zudomon is very tall. In this picture you could compare Joe Kiddo's height to that of Zudomon's horn. Mind, Joe is the tallest of the Digidestined, at least those of Season 1. Anyway, we'll discuss more of that battle between Zudomon and Regalcusmon in another dedicated video. As Regalcusmon is based on the giant oarfish, it shouldn't be all too surprising that it is tall. A giant oarfish is the world's longest bony fish, reaching a length of 8 meters or 26 feet. Some have been said to have reached up to 11 meters, meaning 36 feet. That is incredibly long, almost like a sea serpent. At Regalcusmon's left arm you can see a giant pincer, which can blow away everything around it, including seawater, with plasma discharge from it. And with both the sword and the giant pincer, the Digimon strike fear into those who see them. No wonder, Zudomon is basically a tank, so imagine someone coming along with its horn, that would be something. Before we're going to discuss its potential Digivolution line by going downwards, also known as Digidevolve or D-Digivolve, I'd like to stress out one thing. Let me show a quote. "I assume that the shield was crafted in preparation for the engagement with Zudomon, as no one wants to take a blow from the hammer," by Andres Marrero. Clearly the giant pincer on Regalcusmon's left arm is armor. We do not know why it is wearing it, we simply know it is wearing it. Was it created in preparation for an engagement with a Zudomon? I cannot say that. And reason why I don't really want to say that is because when you put a War Greymon in comparison, War Greymon is also wearing armor with unknown origins, and that immediately after Metal Greymon successfully digivolved. Maybe, just maybe, and this is a huge stretch, you might say that the origins of the armor can be traced back to Andromon's technology, as it is that same technology that can be found on the Metal Greymon. Who knows, but for now the origins of the armor are unknown, it is simply something War Greymon has. As far as we know, Regalcusmon's big pincer is also something it simply has, on the contrary to that sword which it got by taking Zudomon's horn. So to best predict its rookie, champion and ultimate form, I would say we'd need to focus on a few things. We should consider the fact that it has a giant pincer, which can also be found in other Digimon. I think of it as a major trademark of the Digimon, and with trademarks, I mean that some Digimon throughout their Digivolution lines have at least one recognizable feature, may it be in color or in appearance, etc. We should take into account that it is a very good swimmer, so we need to look for a Digimon that at least could have the potential to be as good, or it can also be a Digimon that could go very deep in the ocean. The Digimon we are looking for must be of the Deep Savers family only. Usually when a Mega Level Digimon belongs to only one family, there are more chances that its previous forms also only belonged to that one family, and also vice versa. When a Mega Level Digimon belongs to many families, usually the previous forms also have as many if not more families they belong to. And that's probably because the Megas tend to become more specific depending on which family group they focused more on. Let me give you two examples. Gilmon, who explained in explaining Gilmon Digivolution Land video, belongs to the Nature Spirits, Deep Savers, Metal Empire, Dragon's Roar and Virus Busters family. When you look at its Mega form, Galantmon, it belongs to the Virus Busters, Wind Guardians, Metal Empire and Dragon's Roar family. Another Digimon we talked about was King Chessmon, one who works to create the Chessmon Empire. It belongs to the Metal Empire family only. Its rookie, Chessmon, also only belongs to the Metal Empire family. Now, this trend is obviously not with a 100% accuracy, but still a thing which needs to be considered when searching for Regalcusmon's previous forms. I'll now reply to your comments in the Nostalgia Nat5 community page. For those who are new, I'd like to make a point to try and always include many of your comments, otherwise it is only going to be me who's going to do the talking. I don't really like that, because what's the point of calling ourselves a community if it is only one guy talking? Anyway, we're going to start and look for its potential ultimate form, and afterwards I will give you the line that I feel would be more fitting. Again, it is only me talking, I'm just me, okay, not a Digimon developer. Alright, I quote. Seeing as Regalicusmon is an aquatic mega level virus Digimon, I can quickly draw upon two possible previous forms, Warecidramon, Mega Cidramon, and Dragomon, a dark Cthulhoid Digimon, by Jack Ferring. Now, I can understand why the Cidramon family is being considered. It could be because of the cranium golden armor it is wearing, or maybe because it does have sea dragon features. However, I don't really think any of the Cidramon line would be suited, because once a Digimon reached at least the champion form, for some specific Digimon, their entire line will be determined by name and it is hard to see them deviate from it. Cidramon belongs to the Dramon family, meaning that it is a descendant of Dracomon, the progenitor of all Dramon Digimon, who we explained in the Explaining Dracomon Digivolution Land episode. And to be even more specific, Cidramon also belongs to the Cidramon family, and normally it should not be able to digivolve outside the family unless it fused or something else happened. And the same story goes for Greymon species, the Garurumon species, the Angel species, though this one has many exceptions, like Ophanimon to say the least. So I don't feel any of the Cidramon species would be a good fit. The other example that was used by Jack Ferring was Dragomon, yet another Digimon that obviously deserves its own video. I will also have to disagree with that, because when we look at its trademark, its recognizable features, those would be the tentacles. Heck, its profile even tells that its evolution, its true shape, is that of a Mollusk Digimon, and Gessomon is a Mollusk Digimon, and that along with its line. Dragomon appears more like a side digivolution line of a Gessomon, but we'll talk about that in another video. I quote, Marine Chimeramon is definitely its ultimate slash perfect stage, by Arankar Barnett. I believe that in this video I might disagree a bunch of times, so sorry for that. I'm going to assume that Marine Chimeramon's claw is one of the reasons why some would say it should be Regalicusmon's ultimate. I understand that point, but I think we should think deeper than that. In the Explaining Gazimon video, I remember I talked about Chimeramon. I think I explicitly said that Deltamon would digivolve into a Chimeramon. I don't think I still agree with that theory, because even if that is what is written in its profile, Chimeramon, Marine Chimeramon, and also Machinedramon are what is known as a Chimera, a composition Digimon. These are Digimon that were created with specific purposes. Chimeramon's purpose was to end up fusing with Machinedramon and become the very powerful Millenniummon. Now, as Marine Chimeramon was produced using the same technology as Chimeramon, I would assume it was also created with a purpose. That purpose, to my knowledge, cannot simply be that it has to digivolve into a Regalicusmon, especially when you see what Chimeramon in combination with Machinedramon end up becoming. On top of that, Marine Chimeramon is a combination of about 8 Digimon, and there is none of their data that can be found back in Regalicusmon. Another quote. I could easily see its line being Crabmon, Ebidramon, Scorpiumon, slash Divermon, Regalicusmon, by Steamroller1819. I'll start discussing Divermon first. I do have to say that many believe that Divermon is a great pick for Regalicusmon's ultimate form. While I can't really agree, I realize I can't disagree either, and that's weird, I know. Here are the reasons why some believe Divermon would be a good pick. I quote, I could see Divermon digivolving into this, since it basically hunts underwater and probably beat a Zudumon to get its horn. It resembles a Divermon also, since it has webbed feet and carries hunting supplies. To be brief on this one, I really doubt Divermon would be capable of facing Zudumon and come out victorious, let alone take its horn. I'm not going to underestimate Divermon by any means, but Zudumon is basically a tank with huge muscles and Thor's hammer. To imagine a Divermon, who in the media are always seen acting in groups, no doubt to try and compensate for their individual lack in power. Anyway, to see a single Divermon take the horn of a Zudumon, that would be crazy. When you say that Divermon resembles Regalicusmon because it has webbed feet and carries hunting supplies, well, if Divermon is carrying hunting supplies, like its harpoon, Regal Guzman to me doesn't seem to be carrying hunting supplies, as its armor does look to be strong enough to block heavy attacks. Its armor looks more suited for duels, especially in combination with the sword, so the resemblance does not seem very fitting, at least in my eyes. And when you say webbed feet, you see, when I say trademark or recognizable features throughout an entire line, I mean that a Digimon normally, not always, but normally, has features that always come back. Sometimes it can disappear in one form and re-emerge in another form, or not come back at all. That's always possible. In the Greymon line, usually they always have a cranium shell with three horns. The cranium shell can have a different color, but it remains a similar looking cranium shell, and its skin color is usually orange to yellow. Another example, you have the Ogremon line, who explained in Explaining Ogremon Digivolution line video. When you look at Goburumon and Ogremon, their color remains mostly the same, meaning green. They wear similar type of clothing, but most important, both of them have a habit of holding weapons. Those weapons, depending on the media, have some bone structure to it. That habit disappeared once it became a Digitamamon, even though Digitamamon still has the green legs, but came back once it evolved into a Titamon, who again looks green, etc, etc. The way I see it, it is not enough to simply say that Divermon would digivolve into Regulicusmon because they have similar feet. I'm not saying it is wrong, heck, it might even be that Divermon would digivolve into Regulicusmon. I believe that another Digimon line would best fit the bill. And that line was almost given by Steamroller 1819, but minus the Divermon and minus the Ebidramon, who, by the way, is a Digimon that belongs to the Dramon families, even if it is said that it is a non-conformist Dramon type. And here is a comment against Ebidramon being the ultimate form of Regalicusmon. Yes, it has that shield which looks similar to Ebidramon's pincer, but it is also clearly not Ebidramon's pincer, as the shape is all wrong and it is a shield, not part of Regalicusmon's body. Regalicusmon could have easily fashioned it into a similar shape or taken data from an Ebidramon, but the pincer is too small or the wrong shape and has artificially added details like it was crafted for it to belong to Ebidramon by Andres Marrero. Now, the way I see it, I think that Regalicusmon's line would look more like a Crabmon, Kulamon, Scorpimon, Regalicusmon. Let me explain. You see, based on the fact that Regalicusmon already has a giant pincer on its left arm, and the fact that it also belongs to the Deep Savers family only, a crab would be more fitting because not many animals and not many Digimon that are aquatic have pincers. By the way, I put the emphasis on the pincer because aside of that, what would the trademark of a Regalicusmon be? We know the armor belongs to it, and the sword does not. Let me continue. Regalicusmon's armor has a brown-red kind of color. When we take it back to Crabmon, if you look carefully, Crabmon also has red-brown highlights, referring to the common color of crabs. The difference is that Crabmon stuck metal data dissolved in the net ocean to its body, which likely gave it the color silver. Its belly was not covered though. Now, when you take into account its official champion form, we'll be looking at Kulamon. We now see a fish Digimon covered in a metal armor that did not reach its belly, so we see some similarities with Crabmon already. Assuming that the crustacean Crabmon that covered itself in metal existed since ancient time, it became Kulamon, who is an ancient fish Digimon. I guess that the metal disrupted its development because its body structure is extremely difficult and wrong. Its fins developed like hands and feet, it does not have its pincers anymore. Clearly, something is rather odd with the Digimon. What is said is that it is conjectured that primeval Digimon that originated in the Net Ocean experienced many Digivolutions and took on terrestrial forms. So, through time, Kulamon changed in appearance and developed way differently than a Crabmon, while presumably still retaining the metal covering its upper body. To link it back to Regalicusmon, if you look at its cranium shell which goes to its back, it almost looks like the one of Kulamon, but with a different color. Now, why do I believe that Scorpiumon would be the ultimate? This Digimon took form after a computer virus infected the databanks of a laboratory where the investigations and excavations of ancient life forms were performed. The Digimon that we now see as Scorpiumon took the data of an ancient life form and evolved into a Scorpiumon. And pay attention, Scorpiomon is a Digimon not referring to the scorpion we know today, but rather to the Eurypterids, often informally called sea scorpions, which today are extinct. Depending on the type of sea scorpion, it may or may not have pincers. So for a Scorpiomon, this is already a hint that little by little, the Crabmon influence is coming back. Let me quote from Scorpiomon's profile. I quote, "It became the life form which in ancient times was the apex of the food chain, which had a great appetite and supplied it with an ability capable of allowing it to see food that was the finest quality." Remember when I said that Regalicusmon is considered to be the apex of the food chain? Well, this quote here does not mean that this ancient Digimon was a Regalicusmon, it does mean that Scorpiomon, by stealing the data from these laboratory investigations and excavations, became like the ancient creature that was considered the apex of the food chain. And by the way, to be like someone or something does not mean you are that someone or something. The quote also shows that Scorpiomon, as it gained the skills of that ancient creature, it gained the capability to see food that was of the finest quality. This hints that it has a similar exploring skills like Regalicusmon, who is a pirate and loves to loot. And in order to loot, you need to know what is worthy of being looted. Another point of common Scorpiomon has with Regalicusmon is that Scorpiomon is a Digimon that can be found in the depths of the ocean. It has been stated that if a fight becomes disadvantageous, it uses its sharp tentacles to hoist up the soil of the seabed to hide its body. And only with its radar eye that projects from its head, captures the enemy like a night vision scope, watching for the chance to create a turnabout. And a radar-like vision would obviously be very important if you find yourself in the oceans, where natural light is unavailable. As a mega level, some Digimon tend to take a more humane form, so we can assume that the same would have happened to a Scorpiomon. And maybe I'm stretching things out, but the markings on Regalicusmon's pincer almost look similar to the marking on Scorpiomon's forehead. Anyway, as a Regalicusmon, it appears that Scorpiomon officially became the apex of the food chain. Its armor gained back the red-brown color you'd normally have seen on a Crabmon if not for the metal covering its body. The cranium shell looks like the one on a Coolamon, and on top of that, this is something I forgot to tell by the way, Crabmon is a crustacean, Coolamon is an ancient fish, Scorpiomon is an ancient crustacean, and Regalicusmon became the combination of a fish and a crustacean because of its appearance that is based on a particular fish and the armor that is covering it that looks to be made out of similar material than the pincer, meaning that it should have crustacean origins. Hi guys, this is the end of the video. Because I see we are talking this long already, I don't think it is worth discussing its possible relations with other Digimon. We can always do that in another video. I do want to tell you all that whatever we are claiming here are just theories, so feel free to agree or disagree. Just do that with respect and with elaborated arguments, and let us have debates until the developers come with something more substantial, and then we'll just get back to its origins. In the meanwhile, until we get there, make sure to subscribe to the channel if you wish to see more Digimon related content, drop a like and a comment if you want a particular subject to be explored. If you are new, know that all my videos are placed in different playlists, which are in a chronological order, that way it is easier for you to catch up on the newest and the oldest videos.